Well, hello everybody. I'm Jerry Emge, a realtor with Keller Williams The Lakes in Lake Elsinore, California. And I produce these videos on a regular basis, usually every week by Thursday morning. And each week it's a different topic. If you like my videos, when you get the chance to give them the old thumbs up, please do. And you should subscribe to my channel. Doesn't cost anything. And when you do, you'll get notified. If you hit the little bell, you'll get notified when new videos go live. I think you'll enjoy them. They're just general real estate information. I don't do any selling of homes or anything like that on my videos. So I just hope you enjoy them and learn something. So every video is a new topic. And this video has to do with upgrading your kitchen. When you do a kitchen upgrade, sure, a lot of people have a lot of vanity involved in it, and they want everything the way they want their kitchen to be, assuming they're going to live there forever. That's one way to look at it, and that's okay. But another way to look at updating a kitchen, even for a flip house, is that you want to update it in such a way that it doesn't become outdated very quickly anyway. So, you know, a typical kitchen upgrade can cost anywhere from $30,000 to $70,000, and maybe even more if you put in real high-tech appliances and things like that. One of the things you want to think about as you're doing your upgrade is, can I put this kitchen together in such a way that it doesn't become outdated next year? And this is especially true if you have plans of selling your house in the next few years. And also, you don't want to put extra money into the kitchen that you're never going to get a return on. So I just want to cover a few things that you might want to consider when doing a kitchen upgrade. One of the first things that people talk about when it comes to kitchens and the things they like to see in them is some type of wood flooring, whether it's laminated wood, real wood, or ceramic flooring that looks like wood. They like that look of a wood flooring. 80% of buyers say wood flooring is important. Some say it's real important. So it can go with just about any kind of countertop and any kind of either contemporary or traditional style kitchen furnishings, if you will. Second, consider using what's called a carbaba marble countertop. Carbaba is a pattern, it's usually kind of a whitish color. It goes very well with any kind of decor. As of today, it's generally less expensive than what's really popular now, which is quartz countertops. So it's sort of a little less expensive, and so it'll save you some money. And it's very, very user-friendly in terms of being current with the decor in the kitchen. The next thing is most people put in a backsplash these days. And one of the things to consider about a backsplash is to put in what's called subway tile. Subway tile are rectangular tiles rather than square tiles. So, and they're a little bit bigger, so they have a lot less grout to deal with, number one. And number two, it's very easy to clean and it looks very classy. And so it stays current for a long, long time. So subway tile is an important thing to put in for a backsplash. When it comes to cabinets, people say to put in shaker style cabinets, which are very basic and very simple. They're a wood frame and just very basic panel inside the wood frame. They never get old. They've been around since the days of the shakers. So they're very traditional. And even in a contemporary kitchen, they look great. We have them in our house, and they go very nicely with the rest of our kitchen decor. So stick with white. Now, we didn't do that in our house, but then again, we weren't planning on moving right away. So stick with white. First thing about white cabinets is that it brightens the room and makes the room look bigger. And in a lot of houses today, especially smaller family homes, making things look bigger is a big deal. It adds volume, and it remains a very, very popular color, if you will. So stick with white cabinets, stick with wood flooring, subway tile backsplashes, and carbaba countertops, and you'll do a long way to keeping your kitchen from becoming outdated next year. So, hey, that's all I wanted to talk about today. If you like my videos, again, give them the old thumbs up. Here comes a little bit of information about me. If you like, you can pause the video when you see that. Write down my phone number or email address, and you can always get hold of me to talk about this topic or any of my other videos. I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.